In this problem, we have some 3D geometry. And don't get scared, it's just a unit cube. Now we're going to take this unit cube and we're going to cut it with a plane. We're going to cut it with a plane that goes through vertex D and midpoints M and N of sides AB and CG. I'm going to go ahead and draw that plane in. It's going to hit some point up here on BF as well. So we've cut the cube into two pieces, and we're looking for the volume of the larger piece. I'm going to circle that. I want you on your test, you should circle that word too, so you make sure you go after the right piece. Now that larger piece, I don't know what that is. Not sure what that larger piece actually is, but the smaller piece, well, the back face is a right triangle. The front face is also a right triangle. It's parallel to the back face, and it looks like the front face may even be similar to the back face. Not sure about that, but all these two right triangular faces, they're parallel. This little piece down here might be a frustum. Now, a frustum is what you get when you start with a pyramid and you lop the top of the pyramid off with a plane parallel to the base. Now, there are all sorts of special formulas for finding the volume of a frustum, but I don't know those formulas. However, I know how to handle pyramids. We know how to handle pyramids, so if we can find the big pyramid in here that we've lopped the top off of, well, then we'll know for sure we've got a frustum there, and we'll be able to find its volume. And if we can find its volume, find the volume of the frustum, well, then we can subtract that from the cube to get the big piece. All right, so we have a plan. We're going to find the volume of that frustum. First, we have to make sure it's a frustum. And to do that, we're going to have to go hunting for the big pyramid. That means I need more space. So I'm going to draw the plane in here again. And we're going to say this plane hits edge BF at point X. Now, if this piece down here is a frustum, that means that, well, these three edges, DM, NX, CB, we extend these out in the lines, they're going to go through a common point. Well, do they go through a common point? That's what we need to check. Well, clearly NX and CB intersect. They're both in this side face. They're not parallel. They're going to hit a point somewhere. Same thing for DM and CB. They're both in the bottom face. They're not parallel. They're going to hit at a point. The question is, will NX and DM hit CB, the line, at the same point? Well, these two lines, they're both in the plane we're cutting with. And we know that they're both going to hit CB. But CB can only intersect this plane in exactly one point. So we know that CB hits each of these lines, and it has to hit each of those lines in this big plane, but CB only hits that plane at one point. We have a winner. That's the point where all three must meet. And we've found our pyramid. We've found our big pyramid here, PCND. We take a plane parallel to the base, slice it, slice off this little pyramid, we'll get a little frustum down there. And now we can find the volume of this frustum by finding the volume of the big pyramid, subtracting the volume of the little pyramid. And we've got all these dimensions. This is a unit cube, so BC is 1, CD is 1, CN is 1/2, M is the midpoint of AB, so that's 1/2 as well. Now PBM is similar to PCD, and you can see that MB is half of DC, so we know that B is also the midpoint of PC, so PB is 1, and now we can find the volume of the big pyramid. We have the volume of the big pyramid is 1/3 times the height is 2 times the area of this back face, which is a right triangle with legs, 1 1/2, so we take half the product of the legs. Multiply that out, and the volume of the big pyramid is 1/6. Now, to get the volume of the frustum, we find the volume of the little pyramid, and then subtract that out, and we're left with the frustum. Now, the volume of the little pyramid, well, the little pyramid is similar to the big pyramid, and its sides are half the corresponding sides of the big pyramid. So the volume of the little pyramid is 1/8, the volume of the big pyramid. That means the frustum is the other 7/8. Of the big pyramid. So the volume of the frustum is 7/8 the volume of the big pyramid, which is 7/48. Alright, so now it looks like we got our problem all solved. We just take 7 and add it to the 48. We look back. Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. See, that's why we circled the word in the beginning. So we remember we're going after the larger piece. We found out the frustum has volume 7/48. We want the big piece, not the little piece. We need to subtract that from 1. We get 41 over 48. So P plus Q is 89. And we're done.